A rotating disk, as shown in the figure, moves in positive direction of the x-axis. Now this is the rotating disk and this is moving in the positive direction of x-axis. Find the equation y as a function of x describing the position of the instantaneous axis of rotation if at the initial moment the axis C of the disk was located at point O after which it moved. So this is the disk and he is saying that initially the center of this disk was at O and this disk is describing a plane motion in this xy plane. It is translating and as well as rotating about its center. Clear? Now here what we have to find out, we have to find out the equation for y as a function of x, and this y is describing the position of the instantaneous axis of rotation. And under what condition we have to find out? We have to find out under the condition that when the disk is moving with a constant velocity v, while the disk started rotating counterclockwise with an angular acceleration beta, the initial angular velocity is equal to 0. And in another condition, we have to find the same situation for the instantaneous axis of rotation when the disk is moving with a constant acceleration w and the zero initial velocity while the disk rotates counterclockwise with a constant angular velocity omega. Clear? Now what is instantaneous axis of rotation? Instantaneous axis of rotation. Now this instantaneous axis of rotation is an axis about which the plane motion of this disk. Now here the disk is moving in this xy plane. It is simultaneously rotating as well as it is translating. Now the instantaneous axis of rotation is such an axis about which the motion of this disk is considered purely rotational. Clear? The motion of this disk is considered purely rotational. So we choose such an axis that is called the instantaneous axis of rotation, and this axis about which we consider the motion of this disk purely rotational always pass through the plane of the disk or the plane in which the object is moving, and this axis is perpendicular to the plane in which the object is moving. So here in this case we have the instantaneous axis of rotation along z-axis, and the point through which this instantaneous axis of rotation passes is called instantaneous center of rotation. Instantaneous center of rotation. One more significant thing is that this instantaneous center of rotation or this instantaneous axis of rotation is considered instantaneously at rest, means it has no translational velocity. Clear? And the whole motion, the plane motion of the object about this center or about this axis is pure rotational. Clear? Now how to locate this axis, how to locate this axis or how to locate this instantaneous center of rotation is our next concern. So for that there are two procedures, and I am going to solve this first part by these two methods. So to choose the location of instantaneous center of rotation or instantaneous axis of rotation, we have to make this instantaneous axis of rotation consistent with this result. V is equal to omega cross R. Clear? Now this R, what is this R? This R is the position of center of mass with respect to instantaneous center of rotation. This is one of the way. I am saying that I will going to describe this with two different ways. So in first way, I am taking this R as the position of the center of the disk with respect to the instantaneous center of rotation. So here you can see that this omega is along this z axis, because it is rotating like this in anti-clockwise manner. So omega is along z axis, and this z axis is positive z axis, and v, it is translating along x axis. So v is along positive x axis. So this r, as v is along x axis, this omega is along positive z axis. So here this r, this vector r, must be along negative y axis. Only under this condition, the direction of v will be along x axis. So here the position of the center of the disk with respect to the instantaneous center of rotation must be in the negative y direction with respect to the instantaneous center of rotation. So I am drawing it here. Now this is the disk, clear, and this is the center of the disk. So we have to choose the point, and this point must be along y-axis, and with respect to this point is instantaneous center of rotation, and from this point I am drawing this r, clear, and this r is along negative y-axis. So this is negative y, clear. So this is r, and here he is taking this r magnitude equal to y, clear. So from here I can write this v is the translational velocity, and I can write v, the magnitude of this velocity, omega, and the value of this r, it is y, as he is asking in terms of y. So I put this r vector magnitude equal to y. So from here I get the result v is equal to omega y, clear. Now in this first case, he is saying that the disk is rotating counterclockwise with angular acceleration beta with initial angular velocity equal to 0. So from here we can write that omega, the angular velocity after some time, is equal to beta times t, clear. And using this value of omega from this equation, in this equation of v, I can write v is equal to beta t into y, clear. Also he has said that this disk was initially at O, and it started moving with a constant velocity v, clear, and after some time t, suppose its position is x. So from here I can write x is equal to v into t. Now from here t equal to x by v, and substituting this value of t from here in this equation of v, we get v is equal to beta y x by v. From here we can write y is equal to v square by beta x. So this is our desired result for part A. Now another method to solve this question is that we have taken the velocity of the instantaneous axis of rotation to be zero. So this is the disk and this is the center of the disk. It is moving with a velocity v, and we have to choose the instantaneous center of rotation whose velocity is zero. Clear? And this point, that is the instantaneous center of rotation, must be on this y-axis, and it has to be somewhere here, because as this disk is translating, this point, say this point is P, it has linear velocity v in this direction, same as that of the center of the disk. And for making the velocity of this point equal to zero, so we must superimpose a velocity which must be equal and opposite to this velocity. Let this velocity is v dash. Clear? So the convenient point, or that point of instantaneous center of rotation, must be such that the net velocity of that point is equal to zero. We can't choose this point here because the velocity, this velocity of center of mass is v, and if we superimpose another velocity on it in this direction, then it will not make sense because it is rotating in this manner. Clear? Because in this case we have to choose the position of point P with respect to the center of mass. Earlier we have chosen the position of the instantaneous axis of rotation such that we are taking the instantaneous axis of rotation as reference, and we are drawing the position of center of mass with respect to the instantaneous axis of rotation. But here we are taking the position of this point P with respect to the center of mass. So I am drawing R like this. So it is rotating with omega, and using the result, V dash is equal to omega cross R. So omega is along positive z axis. Clear? And here we have this R, the magnitude of R, I am taking y, and the direction of this R is along positive y axis. Only then, you can see k cross j, only then it will yield this direction of v dash as minus I cap, means along negative x axis. Only then this point can have zero velocity. Clear? So this is the another way to locate the instantaneous center of rotation or instantaneous axis of rotation, and rest of the calculation is same as this result. Clear? So main thing which you have to consider is that you have to make the choice of instantaneous axis of rotation such that it follows this result. Clear? Now the second part of the question, B part, in which he is saying that the disk is moving with a constant acceleration W and zero initial velocity, while disk rotates counterclockwise with a constant angular velocity omega. So B part, so here we have a constant acceleration, that is equal to W, and initial velocity is zero. So after time t, the final velocity is W times t. Now after time t, the velocity of the center of mass is equal to v, that is equal to omega y is equal to W t. Clear? So from here, so this is our one result, and as the disk is accelerating, so its position after time t we can write x is equal to half w t square. Clear? So substituting the value of t from here in this equation, I can write omega y is equal to w, t is 2 under root 2x divided by w. So from here you can write under root 2x w, or from here you can write y square is equal to 2w divided by omega square x. So this is our result for the second part, in which this y is representing the position of instantaneous axis of rotation with respect to x. As the disk is moving in xy plane, the position of instantaneous axis of rotation is varying in accordance with this result.